Captain's log supplemental. We have arrived at Frigis in response to a distress call from Chancellor Laraq. Hmm. Although he claims to have been attacked by the Romulans, we can find no evidence that any battle ever took place.
Sensors are picking up a vessel.
Well, now we have a vessel.
Yellow alert.
A Romulan warbird is on sensors. Locking weapons. Are being hailed.
Do you need a moment, Captain? I understand you humans need to pray before death.
Is this a clone of the other one? Yeah, try another option. My crew and I are prepared to sacrifice ourselves, etc.
My crew and I are prepared to sacrifice ourselves for the Federation. Are you prepared to make that same sacrifice, Commander?
We shall see who becomes the sacrifice. Prepare to die, Captain.
Doesn't matter what we say.
Enemy ship is firing. Nope. The shields
Fire.
Are holding.
Captain. Targeting Romulan warbird.
Damage to the sensor array.
Get him.
Fire.
Torpedo away.
We who are about to die salute you.
Well, close. I prefer the ACDC version. We got him. I was about to take over with some maneuvers, but unnecessary.
The Romulan warbird has been destroyed.
Yay! Everyone claps.
Alert canceled. Condition green.
I cannot begin to thank you for coming to our rescue. If I can help you in any way, please let me know.
I'm sure we will, Chancellor.
I'd like to beam a team down to your planet and talk with you more directly.
You and your crew will be most welcome.
Okay. Any thoughts before we beam down?
Any suggestions, number one?
I'm sorry, Captain,
Mr. Data.
I should...
Counselor,
I'm sorry.
Mr. Worf, you're an ally.
Captain.
You guys are useless. Let's head to... transporter. Ooh, we got Picard this time! See, I'm gonna make this a two-part episode.
Beam down coordinates selected.
Ooh, Picard, Worf, Troy, and Data. Energize! Love it.
I'm glad to meet him face to face.
Right. Now Picard can tell us all kinds of things.
What a curious object. This pyramid resembles some I've seen in ancient Chodak ruins.
Hmm.
This pyramid resembles... These volcanoes probably contribute to the heat and the smell here.
Mm-hmm.
It looks empty in there. Lieutenant Worf is the ship's security chief. Lieutenant Commander Data is in charge of operations for the Enterprise.
So smart. Desert? Troy?
Counselor Troy is the ship's counselor. This reminds me of the Carunian Desert on Paloma 4.
Oh, how so?
Let's interrogate the Chancellor.
It is possible that the Chancellor could give us some useful information.
Troy? Come on. Going through all this.
I sense the Chancellor is willing to give us some information.
You sense correctly.
We should get as much information as we can from Chancellor Laraq.
Okay, let's talk to the guy.
Thank you for allowing us to beam down.
He does a little dance move first. Cha!
I welcome you in the Lawgiver's name. Although the sects have refused to help, I am more than willing to assist you.
Yeah, I wish I had chose Picard instead. Can I just, like, quit out or something? I don't want to quit out in case these options will go. I mean, I would do this and then, like, go into back into this with Picard, but I'm not completely sure it would work that way. How did the Romulans locate you?
How did the Romulans locate you?
The Garidians and the Romulans are allies. The commander of that Garidian ship you met must have gone back and told them.
True.
Do you know why the Romulans came here?
At first, we thought they wanted to help their allies by forcing us to return to Garid. But instead, they demanded information about the Chodak and the Unity device. We remained silent, so they couldn't find us.
Hmm. More information regarding the Chodak.
We were hoping you could give us more information regarding the Chodak.
Our people have always been fascinated by the ruins found when our ancestors arrived here. Over the years, we have learned many things about the Chodak society and technology.
Excellent. Please tell us all of that now. Technology.
Can you describe what you know of Chodak technology?
We do not fully understand the principles behind it, but we've been able to make some of it function. The chameleon field that disguises our world, for example, is a Chodak invention.
Yes, we've just read about that in the ship's computer logs.
What else have you discovered about Chodak technology?
They had an unusual way of navigating that seemed to be based on how long it took to travel between different points at a particular speed. Unfortunately, I don't know how they defined their basic units, so I can't be more specific.
Hmm. Curious.
Is there anything else you can tell me about Chodak technology?
They created special shielding materials which could block out any transporter beams we know of.
Hmm.
Yet, their own transporters could pass through them easily.
Interesting.
What else have you discovered?
They use devices similar to isolinear rods as keys to many of their machines. Here, let me give you one.
Oh, thanks.
How does it work?
When this programmer is twisted around the rod's end, it can alter the rod's settings, making it a sort of all-purpose key.
Hmm.
If you use the programmer properly, you can activate almost any Chodak machine or computer.
A computer. So we've got a skeleton rod, then, apparently. Or we can make one.
Is there anything else you can tell me about?
The crowning glory of their technology was something called the Unity device that made it possible for them to control their far-flung empire.
Can't help but see the word Unity in there.
Do you have any more information about this Unity device?
I think it was a superweapon with almost unlimited powers. When the Chodak lost it somehow, their empire fell apart almost immediately.
Oh. So is that the Star Eater which the Romulans are seeking?
Can you describe what you know of Chodak society?
Their empire spanned this quadrant, encompassing tens of thousands of star systems. It endured for 100,000 years. Then, 900,000 years ago, it disintegrated, almost overnight.
Huh. I wonder how that happened.
100,000 years is a significant time for a political entity to endure. How were the Chodak able to accomplish such a feat?
True. And then my next question would be, how would they disappear so suddenly?
They had a talent for administration. They had an entire planet called Alanor, from which they ruled their empire. The bureaucracy must have been colossal.
Hmm.
What else do you know about Chodak history?
Chodak, friendly or not so much? Was it a friendly bureaucracy, or was it a dictatorship? Or something in between?
We believe that the group which settled here and built these structures was not from the mainstream of Chodak society.
Oh. Like an offshoot of their race or political organization?
How did you arrive at that conclusion?
For one reason, this is a very small base. The structures the Chodak built could not have held more than a few thousand people. This could not have been a major colony.
Hmm.
And for another?
The Chodak settlers often referred to Alinor as the seat of evil, and frequently said that the Unity device, the Empire's chief means of control, had to be destroyed.
This is a lesser sect, or possibly group of renegades who are against the Unity device, the Emperor's chief means of control. Well, definitely seems from this outlook that the Chodak in general were more towards the evil side of things, or a dictatorship. But there were some good Chodak as well, who opposed them. At least, that's the way it looks right now.
The facts you mentioned could support a great many hypotheses, other than the settlers here being rebels.
Yeah, that's one hypothesis, and renegades, rebels, whichever.
There are a thousand more small clues, all pointing to the same conclusion.
Really?
But there is one major mystery which could resolve the question completely.
And what would that be?
What is this mystery?
A century ago, our scientists found a Chodak data crystal. We believe it contains the answers we seek, but unfortunately, the crystal is extremely old and fragile. Our equipment is not sophisticated enough to read it without destroying it.
Perhaps our equipment could read it.
Attempting to read your Chodak data crystal would be an interesting challenge, but I believe it would be well within the capabilities of the Enterprise's computer.
So here's the rod. Is this the thing we put on the rod to make it into like a skeleton rod that we can use on any Chodak computer? I'm guessing so.
Very well. I will entrust the crystal to you. All I ask is that you share whatever you discover to satisfy our own curiosity.
Sure, no problemo.
I must end our conversation now, but I look forward to renewing it at a later time.
As you wish. May the spirit of the lawgiver guide your path through the stars.
All right, so here's the crystal, obviously. Do your dance move.
And I believe we are finished here. Beam us up.
Well, so glad you're taking charge, Data. That's a question I didn't even answer him.
Chancellor Laraq was most helpful. We now know what the Romulans are seeking.
Here's a question. We've got to answer him. We've got to ask him a question, or we didn't forget. We weren't given the option to go back. Their Romulus attack didn't seem to have produced any damage on the planet's surface or anything.
Do you think the Romulans have really found the Unity device?
I think they're looking for it. If they found a device, we're all screwed.
We'd know already if they had.
That's exactly what I was saying.
The device is that powerful?
Well, yeah, it could destroy stars.
I'm not sure, but without it, an empire which spanned this entire section of the galaxy disintegrated overnight.
So yeah, perhaps these rebels actually succeeded in, making off with the Unity device. And without that, whoever they were, ruling with an iron fist was able to rise up against them.
What are your orders, Captain?
I'd like to consider the situation a bit further. Horse 3, we should go. But
I should like to consider the situation a bit further.
Let's save quick. Oh, yeah, we should be on 19 now.
I think it's more than coincidence that references to the Chodak keep appearing everywhere we look.
Chodak.
Maybe that Vulcan scholar Shaynok could tell us some more about them.
Indeed. It's Chodak, by the way, not Chodak.
The ancient Chodak race seems to be at the heart of the current situation. The Vulcan scholar Shaynok was studying some of their ruins. Perhaps he could give us more information.
I have a feeling this is going to be unanimous.
Mr. Worf, your analysis.
Captain, we should check our orders from Starfleet.
Yeah, Worf wants us to check Starfleet orders.
Chancellor Laraq was totally honest with us.
Good to hear. Do we have to go to Horse 3 to talk to Shaynok?
Admiral Williams here. What can I do for you, Captain?
I'd like to confirm our current orders.
Of course. Your orders are to investigate the real reasons behind the Romulan incursion.
Okay. Any more assessment?
What's your assessment of our recent performance?
I'm pleased to note that you contacted the Klingon attack, Captain Kedron. Shall I go on?
No, thank you. What is the current situation, Admiral?
The Romulan incursion is all but over.
Good.
The surviving warbirds have entered the Zatarnus Nebula in pursuit of an unknown objective.
Hmm.
We think they may be after a legendary superweapon built by the ancient Chodak.
Indeed.
Picard out.
On that note.
Primary core access enabled. Systems online.
I want to see if we can warp right there somehow. Cultures, local area missions. Horse 3. Astrogation. No, it's just here. Okay. All right. How do I find my way back? Oh. Evasive maneuvers.
Evasive maneuvers. Hi, Captain.
Go to red alert. A Romulan warbird is on sensors. De-clucking. Locking weapons. Being hailed.
Just saved.
Torpedo locked.
Do you need a moment, Captain?
Oh, brother.
My crew and I are prepared to sacrifice ourselves.
We shall see.
Hit.
Do you need a moment, Captain?
The crew of the Enterprise...
Wait, what?
Fire.
The shields are holding.
Hard break.
Savor your victory well.
The enemy ship has sustained major damage.
Bada boom. Romulan warbird.
The Romulan warbird has been destroyed.
All right. I need to find my way back to Horse 3, and I was afraid. That's what I was afraid of doing.
I think it's more than coincidence.
I would love to talk to Chodak, but I can't.
Warning. Selected destination is an ion storm.
I need to get somewhere. I don't even know what sector it's in.
Captain. The ship's computer has completed its attempt to read the damaged Chodak data crystal we received from Chancellor Laraq.
Cool.
Any success, Mr. Data?
Only in part, sir. Much of the information was corrupted, as we had feared. But there is one section that may be of interest in our current situation.
Indeed, Mr. Data.
As Chancellor Laraq guessed, Frigis was indeed a rebel base.
Hmm.
The crystal explains how the rebels stole information from the main computer on Alinor and used it to attack the Unity device itself.
Wow.
The rebels used a programmable encryption rod to access Alinor's main computer and learn vital information about the Unity device. This information was then used to plan a raid against the Unity device.
We should head for this Alinor, if we can find it.
There is, then, a corrupted section, and a brief mention of a space freighter called the Rinko. I am not certain what the connection is between the freighter and the raid. The complete text of the information may, of course, be found in the ship's computer.
Oh, let's head there.
Primary core access enabled. Systems online.
Missions? Probably have updated information about Frigis now. Federation Starship Enterprise fended off a Romulan attack on Frigis. In gratitude, Chancellor Laraq gave the Enterprise information about the Chodak as well as several still functional Chodak artifacts. Encounter with Romulan fleet on the in the Golder sector. The refitted Romulan fleet crossed into Federation space en masse. Although the fleet did not appear interested in any targets within the Federation, the Enterprise, along with other Federation vessels, was ordered to intercept them. Because the Romulan vessels were refitted with upgraded warp coils and secondary power cores, they proved too fast for the Enterprise to capture one. A Klingon ship, however, did manage to capture and interrogate a Romulan prisoner. The Klingon shared their information with Starfleet Intelligence. The Romulan prisoner reported that the Empire had been invaded by a large unknown force sweeping in from the other side of its borders. After many battles, they learned that the invaders were seeking some ancient superweapon created by the Chodak 900,000 years ago. The Romulans have refitted their fleet in an effort to reach the site of the superweapon before their enemy could. So their enemy is also seeking this out. I wasn't clear on that. Anything new about Horse 3? Okay, so this is mission logs. I wonder if I hit astrogation here, if it'll take us right there. Plus, I want to read. Okay, so that's under missions. Second arrival. Captain's log, supplemental. We have arrived at Frigis in response to a distress call from Chancellor Laraq. Chancellor Laraq, although he claims to have been attacked by the Romulans, we can find no evidence that any battle ever took place. Which is curious indeed. Where do I find this information? Find out where this thing is hidden in the computer. Crazy. We have chameleon, but we've already seen that. Yeah, possibly not a creature at all. Can't find it. Sorry, guys. I'm just... Can't be in tactical. Destinations, no. Analyses. Oh, here we go. Isolinear rod. Preliminary analysis. Chodak isolinear technology was apparently far advanced beyond current Federation levels, judging by the example of this rod. Each isolinear chip within the rod is capable of carrying approximately 10 to the 12th times more information bits than is possible with Federation state-of-the-art. Furthermore, the Chodak isolinear chips can be packed 32 times more densely without mutual interference, allowing for vastly more compact data storage and retrieval. So it's like we're still using 8-inch floppy disks, and they have Blu-ray disks. This particular rod contains encoded information that causes it to respond in a given way to tri-electric field resonances, allowing it to be used as a key to unlock or begin operation of specific mechanisms. The isolinear chips on which the information is encoded are subject to electronic manipulation by the proper implement, meaning that its pattern can be altered. The rod may thus be used as a passkey for many different applications. Programmer? Isolinear rod programmer. The object in question was specifically designed to alter the electronic patterns encoded within Chodak isolinear chips, thus changing their responses to trielectric field resonances. When properly used in conjunction with a specially constructed isolinear rod, it may alter the encoded patterns within the rod and allow it to serve as a passkey in multiple locking mechanisms. And finally, the data crystal. Preliminary analysis. The object in question is a data storage medium using compressed isolinear chips in a crystalline form. Most of its data had been corrupted over millennia of disuse, but the following text is a transcript of the most complete recording. Hold on a second. Need a drink? Very similar to Captain's log, huh? Commander's log, 4392.2. Our forces are ready for the assault on the Unity device. I will be leading the attack, so this will be my final log, whether we succeed or failed. The following data corrupt. We used a programmable encryption rod designed by Chief Scientist Bordelas to access the Empire's central computer on the administration planet Alinor. With the codes we obtained, we will be able to... And then the data is corrupted. I mean, no wonder it's corrupted. It's like 900,000 years ago this thing was recorded. The final attack will commence at corrupted. We'll intercept the space lighter Wrinkle, disable its engines, and jam communications. The Grints will then proceed to the Unity device and engage the chameleon field. With luck, the Unity device sensors will mistake the Grints as the Wrinkle. If our ship succeeds in docking, the assault teams will disembark and... corrupted. Okay, so this space liner Wrinkle, which we're not... we weren't able to determine how this is involved. Apparently the Unity device is on board the space liner Wrinkle. Or maybe not. Well, it's obviously... the Wrinkle is obviously a trusted ship. Maybe they just chose at random a ship in the sector to destroy and then use the chameleon field so that, you know, you don't see two Wrinkles coming up and the game is off. So you destroyed it. And, they plan to destroy it, and then camouflage themselves, or make themselves appear as if they are the Wrinkle itself. Once we have control of the Unity device, we will use its powers to data corrupt into the future and out of the range, reach of the meddling bureaucrats for all time. End of file. Interesting.
I think it's more than coincidence that references to the Chodak keep appearing everywhere we look. Maybe that Vulcan scholar Shaynok could tell us some more about them.
Hmm. Alright, we should... Hold on.
Primary core access enabled. Systems online.
Thank you. It won't even let us move until it's finished saying that. Horse 3, can we go into astrogation? Damn it. Gotta find our way to this horse. Hold on a second.
Primary core access enabled. Systems online.
Okay, here we find it. Sector. Okay, I think this is what we're looking for. Sector 544.
Sir, we are receiving a signal from Starfleet. It is Admiral Williams.
Sorry we're taking so long, Williams. We're total noobs. We're trying to figure out where Sector 544 is.
On screen. Greetings, Admiral. What can we do for you?
An unknown alien race has just crossed the neutral zone into Federation space. All attempts to communicate with them have failed.
Oh my.
Are they hostile?
Definitely. So far, every ship and outpost in their path has been attacked, disabled, and left for dead.
Uh-oh.
Do we have any idea of their objectives?
That's the strangest part. It looks like they're pursuing the Romulan fleet into the Zatanna's Nebula.
Yeah, they're looking for this thing. And I just want to talk to Shaynok.
Then my first instinct would be to let them go with our blessings.
I wish we could. Unfortunately, Outpost Delta 08 lies directly on their present course. We can't afford to lose it. Proceed at best possible speed to the Yaz system and intercept.
Okay, never mind Shaynok then.
Understood. Picard out.
What are your orders, Captain?
Set course for the Yaz system. Maximum warp. Engage.
Make it so. Well, can't help but think I'm missing something. Because I'm not talking to Shaynok.
Warning. Entering Nebula.
Okay. Thanks for watching, everyone. See you in the next episode. Endure. In enduring, grow strong.